In the last video, we created the blog index page by fetching posts from the WordPress GraphQL API. And this is how it looks. However, there was one important thing that we missed in that video. That is displaying the published date below the post titles. But that's not as straightforward as it seems. You will soon realize why. Looking at our GraphQL query, you can see that we are fetching the published date as part of the data. Let's try outputting it as it is. So go to the blog index route file. Then create a new div element below the heading tag. Give it some padding by adding the class py-4, and the text is published on followed by the variable post.date. And this is how it looks now. It's a valid date string, however, it's not quite readable. It contains the date and the timestamp. It's an ISO standard date string with the uppercase letter T in the middle. So we want to convert that into a more readable format before outputting on the page. But how to do that in JavaScript? In this context, how to convert date formats in Next.js? That's where we can use a library called DateFNS. It's a JavaScript library that gives a comprehensive list of functions to manipulate date strings. For instance, you can find the distance between two dates, convert a date string from one format to another, output the current date and time, and all such things you can imagine. The library can be used in the browser as well as in a Node.js environment that is on the server side, which implies we can use it with Next.js, and the main advantage is that it's lightweight. So no need to import the entire library to our project. Instead, we can just import the individual functions we want. In our case, to manipulate the post date, we require two functions, the parseISO function, which parses a given ISO date string and returns a JavaScript date object. In addition to that, we also require the format function. Here is the documentation. The format function is the one that allows us to play with different date formats. Here in this table, you can find an extensive list of patterns or format letters you can use with this function. For instance, using for lowercase letter y gives the year in 4 digits. Similarly, the uppercase letter m gives the full month name. And the lowercase letter d outputs the date of the month 1 to 31. Okay, we want to install the DateFNS module in our application. So open the terminal. Then run the command npm install datefns. It's already up to date as I had it installed before recording this video. Now let's create a custom date component so that we can reuse it on any page. So inside the components directory, create a new file called date.js. The purpose of this component is to receive an ISO format date string, convert it using the DateFNS functions, and return it in HTML format. For that, we want to import the required functions from the library. As I already said, the first one is the parseISO function, and the other one is the format function. We can do that in a single line using object destructuring. then export the default function date. The function accepts one argument, which is the date string we received from the WordPress API. Now let's call the parse ISO function and pass the date string. Assign its value to a constant named date. The value will be a JavaScript date object. Then comes the return statement, which returns an HTML time tag. Just to verify what the date constant is, let's try outputting its data type using type of date. Going back to the index.js file, we want to import the new date component. Scroll down to the post snippet area. Here we want to call the date component below heading and pass the date string as a prop. Date string equals post dot date. The output on the right side confirms that it's an object, that is a date object. Again, back to the date.js file. To access the date from this object and convert it, we can use the format function. So call the format function. The first argument is the date object and the second argument is the pattern. To output the full month name, we can use four uppercase letters L. Okay, now we got published on December. Then to output the date number, add the lowercase letter D. Okay, then the year in four digits. Yeah, that's what we wanted. Published on December 21, 2022. In addition to that, the time tag can also have a date time attribute, which contains the date string without conversion. It can be good for SEO. Maybe we can shorten the month name to three letters. So delete one of these letters. I think that looks better. Open the inspect element tool and we can see our time tag. That's all for this video. I hope now you understand how to convert date formats in Next.js.